In the category of microorganisms, the next organism to study is fungi. Singular fungus and plural fungi. It is a class which is already described according to the Whitaker's five kingdom classification system, which we have already learned. So let us understand the general characteristics of the class fungi. These are eukaryotic, unicellular or multicellular organisms. In general, unicellular fungi are called as yeast and multicellular are called as molds. The habitat where these fungi occur, basically they are universal, terrestrial. Generally, they are found in soil which is rich in dead, decaying organic matter, where they receive sufficient nutrient moisture for the growth. In tissues of plants and animals, they live on decaying organic matter and living organisms. They are also found in aquatic environments, in fresh water, pond water, as well as polluted water. They grow on foodstuffs and responsible for the spoilage of food. Say for example, bread, jams, pickles, fruits and vegetables. So they are responsible for contamination of food and drinking water. The mode of nutrition, how do they obtain their nutrients, or they generate the source of energy and source of carbon. Fungi are not photosynthetic. They are not photosynthetic like algae, generally because they do not contain any chlorophyll pigment or any light harvesting pigment. So the mode of nutrition is non-photosynthetic. It is absorptive. That means the solubilized carbon, nitrogen and different types of nutritive sources are absorbed by the hyphae or the cells. They are heterotrophic or chemoorganotrophic. That means they use organic compounds as a source of carbon and energy. So they are dependent on the external supply of ready food. So these are chemoorganotrophic organisms that derive their energy from oxidation of organic substances. The fungal hyphae secretes certain extracellular enzymes that can degrade the insoluble food material or complex food material into the simple one or in simple form, which can be absorbed by the hyphae of fungi. Generally, there are two types of modes of nutrition, saprophytism and parasitism. So there are some fungi which are saprophytic fungi. This means that these fungi, they grow on dead and decaying matter, whereas some fungi are parasitic fungi. That means these fungi are dependent on other living organisms for their growth and multiplication. The structural component of some fungi, in case of multicellular fungi, is called as thallus. In general, multicellular fungi are called as molds and unicellular are called as yeast, as it was mentioned earlier. So the thallus, it is a large body of the multicellular fungi which consists of microscopic tubular filaments. These filaments are called as hyphae, singular hypha. When these hyphae combines together, it leads to formation of mycelium, and these hyphae, each of them, it originates from the germination of spores. These spores may be sexual spores or asexual spores. So these hypi forms mycelium. When so a bundle of hypi, we can call it as mycelium, and when mycelia comes together, it leads to the formation of a large body, and that large body, it is called as thallus. In case of some fungi, this thallus, it further develops into a more matured form, and that matured body is called as mushroom or fruiting body. So these hypi, it may be aseptate or it may be septate. So aseptate hypi generally contains a single set of nucleus, whereas a multinucleate mycelium, it is called as cenocytic, which is the condition or which is the case which is seen in case of aseptate hypi. These are the pictures. So in case of septate mycelium, we can see that each cell has a septum, and it leads to the formation of separate cells, whereas this septa or septum is absent in case of aseptate mycelium, and that leads to the condition of cenocytic. Next characteristic is the cellular structure of the fungus. These are eukaryotic structures which contains nucleus, mitochondria, endoplasmic reticulum, Golgi bodies and ribosomes, as we have studied earlier. Along with that, it contains inclusions such as lipid globules, granules of glycogen, oil droplets, volatine granules, which acts as a stored food source. The cell wall of fungi, it contains 80-90% of carbohydrates, and remaining are proteins and lipids. A typical feature of a fungal cell wall is that there is presence of a polymer called as chitin. So this is one of the major differences between the cell wall of plant cell and cell wall of a fungal cell, that in case of cell wall of plant cell, there is presence of cellulose, whereas in case of cell wall of a fungal cell, it is rich in chitin. There are some classes of fungi such as oomycetes and hypochitridiomycetes. They do not contain cellulose in their cell wall. They do contain cellulose in their cell wall. Chitin is a polymer. It is a linear polymer just like cellulose and starch. It is made up with the monomers of N-acetyl glucosamine, which are linked by beta-1,4 glycosidic bonds, which are glycosidic bonds covalently linked. The chitin may be intermeshed or it is complexed with the other glucans like callose, which consist of beta-1,3 linked glucose residues. These are the some pictures of fungi. Penicillium, we can see there are conidiophores on which the spores are born. Second picture is of Aspergillus, Rhizopus and Mucor. We can see the differences. On the upper hand side, Penicillium and Aspergillus, the spores are produced outside of the stalk, whereas in case of the bottom picture, that is Rhizopus and Mucor, we can see that the spores are produced within a sac called as sporangium. This is the structure of a typical fungal cell that shows the presence of all the eukaryotic cellular components. This is the structure of arrangement of yeast cells. In this case, we can see that the yeast cells are unicellular. However, they remain attached to each other and they appear as mycelium, but it is not true mycelium. That is why it is called as pseudomycelium. The methods of reproduction in fungi are by two ways: asexual mode of reproduction and sexual mode of reproduction. Asexual reproduction is by the methods of fragmentation, budding, fission, and spore production. So there are some fungi which can only reproduce by asexual mode of reproduction. They are called as fungi imperfecti. It is the name of the class. That means these fungi are generally considered as imperfect fungi, in which there is a lack of sexual reproduction. So they only reproduce by the mode of asexual reproduction, fragmentation, budding, fission, and by means of production of asexual spores. Fragmentation, we have learned, there is a long filament which undergoes degradation. It breaks at certain point and leads to the formation of small pieces, and this is its individual piece is responsible for the formation of, or it germinates to form a complete body of fungus. Then budding, which is commonly seen in case of yeast. Fission is generally seen in case of fission yeast. And the most common method is production of asexual spores. Spore is a very small propagative, reproductive, and survival unit that separates from a hypa and sporogenous cell, which gives rise to new individual fungi. In general, the asexual spores are of two types: sporangiospores and conidia. Sporangiospores are formed within a sac. It is called as sporangium. And this sporangium, it is born on sporangiophore. There are two types of sporangiospores: motile sporangiospores and non-motile sporangiospores. Motile are called as zoospores and non-motile are called as aplanospores. Other type of asexual spores are conidia. These are freely born or formed on conidiophore, and these are provided with one or two flagella. These conidia are of two types: thallospores and conidiospores, or called as true conidia. This is the picture of zoospore. It is a single propagative cell, consists of flagella. These are the aplanospores, which do not contain flagella, and they are non-motile. This is the picture of different types of conidia. For example, conidia produced by Alternaria alternata, extreme left, the middle one, Pacillomyces, we can see oval shaped conidia form on the stalk, and towards extreme right, one more species of Penicillium, we can see the formation of conidia on the stalk. Next way of reproduction is sexual reproduction in fungi. So sexual reproduction in fungi is mediated through three steps: plasmogamy, karyogamy, and meiosis. Plasmogamy means the fusion of two sexual cells. How do you identify sexual cells? Male sexual cell and female sexual cell, and it is dependent, or it is decided on the basis of composition of nucleus, a female nucleus or a male nucleus. which is the identity of that particular sexual cell. And another feature may be the structural dissimilarity. That means a female cell will appear different from the male sexual cell. Second event is karyogamy. So after plasmogamy, two cells of opposite mating types, they fuse with each other, and then it leads to formation of a single cell that brings the two different nuclei into a single set of cytoplasm. The process is karyogamy, which includes fusion of two different nuclei, one from male, another from female sexual cell. So fusion of nuclei that results in the production of a diploid zygote nucleus. So whenever there is presence of a single set, the condition is called as N. Whenever, now in this cell, there will be presence of two sets of nuclei. So N plus N, so it will become 2N. So that will be the condition in case of diploid zygote cell. The third step is meiosis. Meiosis, as we have learned earlier, it is a reductive type of division. So it involves the genetic recombination resulting in the production of genetically different individuals. As a result of sexual reproduction, four types of spores may be formed depending on the type of fungus: zygospores, ascospores, oospores, and basidiospores. Zygospores, all these spores are having different properties or different ways of formation. For example, ascospores are the sexual spores which are produced within a sac called as ascus sac. Basidiospores are produced on a club-shaped structure of fungus called as basidium. Zygospores are produced as a result of fusion of two similar appearing gametes. So these gametes or sexual cells, they appear similar. Structurally they are similar, but genotypically they are different. One is carrying male nucleus, another one is carrying female nucleus. And oospores are produced as a result of fusion of two dissimilar appearing gametes. That means the gametes or the sexual cells, male are appearing different than the female gametes. Let us understand the general life cycle of fungus. It involves sexual reproduction and asexual reproduction. Remember that asexual reproduction occurs only in case the class of fungus in which only asexual reproduction occurs, it is called as imperfect fungi. In their life cycle, this step of sexual reproduction won't appear. So this is in general asexual reproduction in case of fungi. Let us begin it with a stage of propagative cell, that is spore. So this spore, it germinates when it gets nutrients, moisture or water, and as a result of germination, it leads to formation of hyphae. These hyphae comes together to form mycelium, and these mycelium then further develop into thallus, or in some cases into the fruiting body, that again leads to the formation of spore producing structures. And this is how the cycle continues. This involves the process of mitosis. In case of sexual cycle, sexual reproduction, the mycelium, the basic unit is hypa. These hypa are of two types, positive and negative. Positive are represented as male gametes, and negative are represented as female gametes. So there are two types of gametes, sexual cells, male and female. These male and female gametes, when combined together through the process called as plasmogamy. We have learned what is plasmogamy, fusion of cells. Then the nuclei are brought into a single cell, which is followed by the process of karyogamy. We have learned karyogamy is the fusion of nuclei, as a result of which it leads to production of a single cell called as zygote, which is a diploid cell. Then in this zygote, the nuclear recombination occurs, that is meiosis, and which leads to the formation of sexual spores. And when these sexual spores, will be of different genotypes, positive genotype and negative genotype. So in case of meiosis, there is a condition of 2N, and in case of spores, the status of the nucleus will be N, which may further germinate to form mycelia, and the process of this sexual reproduction then continues. This is another picture that shows the fungal life cycle, the asexual life cycle that starts with the hyphae, where the status of the nucleus, status of the cell is N. It undergoes nuclear multiplication, that is mitosis, that leads to formation of haploid spores, which further germinate back to form the hyphae and mycelia. So here the status remains N. This is a sexual reproduction that begins with plasmogamy, where the two sexual cells or gametes, positive and negative, here they are represented by a black dot and red dot. So they are brought into a single cell through a process called as plasmogamy, that leads to formation of a zygote through the event of karyogamy, that is a mixing of two nuclei. So here the status of the zygote cell will be 2N. Further, meiosis leads to formation of haploid cells called as spores, in which the status of nucleus is 1N. When these spores germinate, it leads to the formation of individual hyphae having the nucleus status of 1N. It may be of positive type and negative type. This is the life cycle, sexual reproduction in case of ascomycetes in detail. So the life cycle, it begins with the hyphae. So these hyphae, it may be of different types, positive hyphae and negative hyphae. So these hyphae, they further develop into the fruiting body, and it leads to further production of conidia. So that is the asexual reproduction. Then these conidia, they germinate to form positive hyphae or negative hyphae. Then these positive hyphae and negative hyphae during sexual reproduction undergo fusion of cells. The event is called as plasmogamy, which happens in this fruiting body called as ascocarp. So within this cell, these two hyphae or cells of hyphae, they fuse to form a diploid cell through a process of karyogamy that leads to formation of a zygote, through a process of meiosis that leads to formation of four nuclei, two of each type, two female and two male. Further, the number of these nuclei, it increases through, or it doubles through, a process of asexual way of reproduction, that is mitosis. So where we can see the number 4 is doubled to number 8. So this is the ascus sac, that is why the spores are called as sporosaurs, and these spores are then released out. They are of positive type and negative type. Individually they germinate to form respective positive hyphae and negative hyphae, and this is how these ascospores, germinated ascospores, which leads to formation of mycelia, then it further develops into the formation of conidia of different types, and the cycle continues. This is the picture which is in case of the formation of basidiospores. In case of basidiospores, we can see that the hyphae, haploid mycelia, positive type and negative type. So one is represented by green color dots, the nuclei, and another one is represented by red colored nuclei. So both represent positive and negative nuclei. So these mating type, positive and negative, they fuse with each other, that is the plasmogamy, that leads to formation of a dikaryotic mycelium. This everything happens in a large fruiting body, which is called in case of mushroom, which bears gills with basidia. So basidium, it is a flat surface on which the spores are born. Through the process of karyogamy and meiosis, it leads to formation of a diploid cell. Further, meiosis will leads to the formation of haploid spores, which are produced on the basidium, called as basidiospores. This is the same life cycle of sexual reproduction in case of basidiomycetes. Then how zygospores are produced? So here, as we have seen the definition of zygospore, zygospores are produced as a result of fusion of two similar appearing gametes, means the gametes, positive and negative gametes, are structurally similar. So here we can see that this is the fully grown fungus, which is made up with two types of hyphae, positive and negative. So these are the two hyphae having a nuclear status of 1N1N. These two then fuse with each other through a process of plasmogamy, followed by that. So this is how fusion of two dissimilar gametes leads to formation of this zygospore. Then the zygospore, within this zygospore, the nuclear multiplication takes place, that leads to the formation of nuclei having a status of 1N, which then further develop into a full fungal body. This is the sexual reproduction in case of oomycetes, that means the fungi that produce oospores. This is the way by which oospores are formed. This is the asexual way of reproduction, in which we can see the fungal body. So this bears the primary zoospores. These zoospores germinate to form secondary zoospores, and these secondary zoospores, which are motile, leads to formation of fungal hyphae, and through the process of this asexual reproduction, the replication, the process of multiplication of fungus by a sexual way, it happens. In case of sexual reproduction, this fungus, it bears the sexual gametes. Now in this case, these sexual cells are of structurally different types. The male structure is called as antheridium and the female structure is called as oogonium. So oogonium and antheridium, they fuse through a process called as plasmogamy, then karyogamy, and as a result of meiosis, the final product is oospores, which further germinate to form individual hyphae and fungal structure of positive type and negative type. The importance of fungi. Fungi are important in relation to the symbiotic process. There are two important associations of fungi, lichens and mycorrhiza. Both are required or environment friendly processes. Lichen, it is a symbiotic association of fungi with that of algae. It is a mutualistic association in which fungi absorbs water and important minerals from the soil and it supplies them to algae, whereas photosynthetic algae supply food required for the growth of fungi. Mycorrhiza, it is another important association of fungi with the roots of higher plants. It is also a mutualistic association in which fungi infect the roots and function as root hairs. They absorb water and minerals from the soil and transmit them to roots of tree. The tree provides nutrients to the fungus. There are certain uses of fungi, as we have learned in fermentation technology, that fungi are responsible for the production of chemotherapeutic agents called as antibiotics, such as penicillin, vitamins, organic acids, enzymes, and the food products like cheese and many more dairy products. Yeast are basically useful in the fermentation process. They are useful in the production of alcohol, that is ethanol. They are also useful in the making of bread. Such yeast are called as baker's yeast. And the yeast which are used in the production of alcohol or alcoholic beverages are called as brewer's yeast and wine yeast. Brewer's yeast, it is a variety of yeast which is used in the making of beer. The process is called as brewing. Another type of yeast, that is wine yeast, is used in the making of wine. There are certain clinical important fungi which are responsible for the production of diseases in humans also. So these diseases are gastrointestinal tract infections, respiratory tract infections, that means pneumonia. They are responsible for the production of pneumonia, and a very common disease is the skin infection and urinary tract infection. These types of infections are very difficult to treat. Fungi are also responsible for causing the spoilage of food. In plants also, these fungi are responsible for the production of several infections and diseases, which is responsible for the loss of crops due to formation of wilt, rot, and dieback.